Welcome. We are seeing about the control structure chapter that is in PL bar SQL. Already we have shown the sequential structure and selection structure. The two topics we have already discussed. And today we will see about the looping structure. As you already know, looping has nothing but a series of instructions that is performed or executed repeatedly. There are many different looping statements that can be used depending upon the situation. But one of the conditions is the programmer has to write the loop correctly to make it perform a particular task to execute specific number of times. This is what the definition of a looping structure. Now we will enter into looping structure. So looping means it is nothing but iteration. Iteration in the sense a looping repeats a statement or a series of statements a specific number of times as defined by the programmer. So user would use a loop to repeat a series of statements many times rather than typing the same statements many times. So repeated in the task execute ahanumo, anga looping abding for a concept I use pandro. Three types of looping statements that are available in PL bar SQL. One you call it as a basic loop, second one while loop, and third one for loop. So each loop has its own different syntax and each works differently from the other type. We will see one by one. So first one is the basic loop. Basic loop, as the name says, it is a loop that is performed repeatedly. When the loop is entered, all the statements in the loop are performed. When the bottom of the loop is reached, the control shifts back to the top of the loop. So the loop will continue infinitely. So an infinite loop is also called as a never-ending loop. If it executes, it can be said as a logical error in the programming. So one way to terminate a basic loop is you have to add an exit statement inside the loop. So or loop start ana kandipa end aganum basic loop la and the loop continue infinite execute aite irukkaradanala you have to use exit statement to terminate that loop. So the exit statement in a loop could be an independent statement or it could be a part of an if statement. Independent statement na ipaniya exit nu solala illa you can use with the help of if statement also. For example, if variable count is greater than 10, then you are saying exit end if. Like this, you can say. And also, you can add a condition with the optional when class. That will end the loop when the condition becomes true. In the mari when class, you can use the exit condition. That is, when your count is greater than 0, you can loop exit. So, one way is used along with if, another one is independent. By using the when class. So the condition is not checked at the top of the loop, but it is checked inside the body of the loop. It is a basic loop would work. Body kulla dhaan condition check pandrom. So the basic loop is performed at least once because the condition is tested after entering the body of the loop. So such kind of loop we call it as a post-test loop. Post-test loop. So this is a example that is given for counter control to basic loop. You're using a counter to control the number of loop execution that you're declaring in the declaration part as a count and some average or two other variables that have been declared in the declaration section begin. Variable count is equal to one. Here you're initializing the counter and here you're summing with that counter, that is sum plus count. You're incrementing the counter and here you're giving the condition exit when we count is greater than 0. So here what are you going to do in this program is you're going to just find the average of the numbers from 1 to 10. 1 to 10 average is 5.5 and it's been calculated with this looping statement, basic loop. The next type of loop is while loop. It is an alternative to the basic loop and it is performed as long as the condition is true. That is totally opposite to basic loop as this while loop. Because the condition is performed as long, the particular task of looping carries over when the condition is true. It terminates when the condition becomes false. Condition false adhishana, terminate item. If the condition is false at the beginning of the loop is not performed at all. So condition true while is amattumna. Looping statement execute out. Conditions false are in the it will terminate. So like basic loop, it does not need an exit statement to terminate. It does not need an exit statement. Basic loop plus exit statement on a use panna inga vandu use panna maatom. So this is the syntax of the while loop. While this is a keyword, you're giving the condition, loop is the keyword, you're looping statements from one to end and end loop. So whenever you start the while loop, you have to give as end loop semicolon. This is the example for the counter controlled while loop. Counter controlled means you're using a counter variable. That's all. This is the difference between the basic and while loop example. The same program is being discussed here. So while variable count less than 10 to 10, loop, the condition is being given here. So whenever this condition is true, then only these two statements will execute. The counter incrementation, the counter value that has been added to some of these two processes has been carried over when this condition is true. If it is false, this loop will not at all execute. The program is same program that has been discussed in the basic. The basic loop, it is you are going to find the average of 10 numbers. The only difference is here the while part. So comparing this figure of a basic loop, this program of basic loop and this program of while loop, we will give a summarization like basic loop is performed as long as the condition is false. But in while loop, it is performed as long as the condition is true. Basic loop plus false are the matter execute ahum, while loop plus true are the matter execute ahum. It tells the condition inside the loop. So it can call it as a post test loop. And while loop checks the condition before entering the loop. So it will call it as a pre test loop. It is performed at least one time. Basic loop is performed at least one time. And while loop is performed zero or more times. It needs the exit statement to terminate. Basic loop needs the exit statement to terminate. And while loop, there is no need for an exit statement. Since here you are not using any exit statement in while loop. So these are the basic differences that exist between a basic loop and a while loop. Next is for loop. It is the simplest loop user can write. Unlike the other two types of loops, the user does not have the process of initialization, testing, and increment and decrement the loop separately. They can able to do with the help of the loop's header. You see the syntax. For is a keyword and loop is a keyword. Counter in is also a keyword. Reverse is also a keyword. Lower to upper looping statements end loop. That is previous under loop la meaning an incrementation, initialization, test, increment, decrement. Adalathiyum thani thaniya paathinga. Idu ellathiyum indha edathila loop header la kudukkaradha for loop oda periya advantage. Okay, incrementation the lower upper la kudukringa counter value inga reverse loop pananuma reverse means higher to lower lower to higher abingiradha the reverse oda option vechi neenga decide panikalam. By default the counter starts at the higher value and decrement by 1 with every loop execution. The keyword reverse use panna appadina it is used for varying the counter in the reverse order or from a higher to a lower value. So this is example, the same program that has been in a return in for loop. This is the for loop statement. Here the counter use pandrom 1:10 ingra condition inga vekkrom end loop ingradukulla nama the summation kudukom. That's the difference between a for loop la எல்லாத்தையும் ஒரே லைன்ல கொண்டு வந்துடுறோம். இன்னும் கொஞ்சம் உங்களுக்கு புரியுற மாதிரி சொல்லணும்னா இங்க அந்த 15 லைன்ஸ் பக்கமா நீங்க எழுதுனதை இங்க 16 லைன்ஸ் பக்கமா எழுதுனதை இங்க 12 லைன்ஸ்ல நம்ம முடிக்கிறோம். பிகாஸ் எவ்ரி திங் ஹஸ் பீன் இன்க்ளூடட் இன் ஃபார் லூப்ஸ் ஹெட்டர். The next type of the loop is nested loop. Nested அப்படிங்கிற வேர்டோட மீனிங் உங்களுக்கு தெரியும் ஒண்ணுக்குள்ள ஒண்ணு. So user can use the loop with another loop is called the nested loop. When the inner end does not automatically end the outer loop in closing. Inner loop end ஆயிடுச்சுனா it does not mean outer loop end ஆயிடுச்சுனா. So user can end the outer loop within the inner loop by labeling each loop
and then using the exit statement. இந்த மாதிரி தான் அவங்க வந்து end பண்ணனும். So exit when, exit the current loop, but exit out loop when also exit the outer loop. The loop labels is the same naming rules as been used for identifiers. The loops are labeled before the keyword loop on the same line or on a separate line. Same line லயும் நீங்க வந்து அந்த loop label பண்ணலாம், இல்லைன்னா separate line லயும் label பண்ணலாம். The loop label is enclosed within two pairs of angle brackets. In the brackets use பண்ணி தான் loop label வந்து நம்ம enclose பண்றோம். So we'll see how it is. This is the outer loop, this is the inner loop. So angle brackets use பண்ணிருக்கோம் அப்படிங்கிறது தான். இந்த இன்னர் லூப் வந்து வெளியே போகணும்னா எக்ஸிட் வென் கண்டிஷன் யூஸ் பண்றோம். அவுட்டர் லூப் வெளியே போகணும்னா எக்ஸிட் அவுட் லூப் வென் கண்டிஷன் இந்த மாதிரி கண்டிஷன் யூஸ் பண்றோம். ஃபுல்லாக வெளியே போகணும் இன்னர் லூப்ல இருந்துன்னா லூப் இன் லூப்னு சொல்றோம். அவுட்டர் லூப் ஃபுல்லாக வெளியே போகணும்னா இன் லூப் அவுட் லூப்னு சொல்றோம். So this is what called as nested loops. Next we will see about the nested blocks. So PL bar SQL block may contain another PL bar SQL block. That is, it can be nested. So the execution starts with the outer block and continues with the inner block. The outer block will start at the inner block. The variables declared in the outer block are global to the inner block and they are accessible in the inner block also. But the variables that have been declared in the inner block are not accessible in the outer block. Outer la irukkiradhu inner access panikka mudiyum, but inner block ku irukkiradhu outer block access panna mudiyadhu. This is an example. So this is the first part and here this is the second inner block. So this is the outer block, this is the inner block. So variable 1 அப்படிங்கறத வந்து இந்த block யூஸ் பண்ணிக்க முடியும். ஆனா variable 2 அப்படிங்கறத outer block யூஸ் பண்ண முடியாது. So இந்த இடத்துல inner block முடியுது, இந்த endல outer block முடியுது. So variable 1ங்கறது outer block இந்த இடத்துல இந்த எங்க வேணாலும் நீங்க வந்து யூஸ் பண்ணலாம். Since it is an outer blocks ஓட variable அப்படிங்கறது. So hope you would understand what we have seen about the looping structure and the nested block. So these are our control structures and nested blocks. So the work and functionality in that we will check. Now we will see about the SQL and PL bar SQL in the next class.